Good evening, YouTube. So, a viewer of mine, Kevin, asked a really good question, which is, what tools should he be getting, or what tools am I using to work on the Ferrari? So, I thought that's a great idea for a video. I'm going to show you all the tools that I have. I know that means you guys are going to tell me all the tools I should buy. Maybe keep it to a low roar, because I know there's plenty of tools I should buy, but I'm not going to go out and buy them all, okay? I don't have unlimited resources. But so far, these tools have done everything that you've seen on this car, and all my videos have been done with the tools that I currently have. So I'll show you what I got and tell you which ones I think are really good buys and which ones aren't. So also, I really don't care that you think that my Craftsman tools are crap or whatever. So please spare me the shit, okay? I don't fucking care that I bought Chinese tools. They work fine. So please. All right. Anyway, let's show you the tools. All right, we'll start with the fun stuff. I do have a big air compressor. It's a 30-gallon. I don't use it that much because it's really loud, but I have two impact guns. This one is an old piece of crap. This one is a new high-powered one that can put out like 1,000 foot-pounds or something like that. So it's quite powerful. Here we go. I have a tire pressure gauge. I just bought this. I haven't used it yet. It's a motivator or a motive. See? There you go. Motive. So this is a power brake bleeder, so you can basically pressurize your brake system and bleed them with one person, and it's a lot easier, so that's good. Behind that is my old vacuum operated bleeder kit, which is not as good, so I don't really think I'll be using it much more. I have a bearing puller set, so you can see it's got different sized jaws. So this is really handy. I use this when pulling off my wheel bearing. It's probably one of those tools that, again, you're only going to use occasionally unless you're, maybe really working on cars frequently. We have a battery charger. This is a kit for my shocks to adjust them, so it's a KW coilover kit. Right here I've got a, I think it's 15 to 150 foot-pound torque wrench, and then my big one, which is goes up to 250 foot-pounds, so they're both half-inch drive. What do we have up here? I have a transfer pump, which I haven't used yet. I bought that, thought I would need it, and I didn't. I have a air cutoff tool if I ever need to, like, saw anything. What is in this? I don't remember. Oh, yeah, okay. This is my compression check tool. Probably don't need those very often, so that I bought when when Meg's car blew up. That is my old 1.5-ton Craftsman floor jack that I've had for probably 20 years. It's been working great. And a little stool, which is also great. I have my floor ramps, so I like the composite ones instead of the metal ones. I think they have a higher safety rating. And a creeper, which I absolutely never use. All right, so I've got a workbench, which is covered in shit, but got a vise. We got a hex Allen wrench set, so you can see lots of different size Allen wrenches. I use this one a lot. This is a very handy kit. This is one of those cheap ass Amazon ones. This is just a O-ring kit, a bunch of electrical connectors, another little little screwdriver kit that has all sorts of different hex heads and safety bits and Torx bits and weird things that you'll never use, but it's got everything. So again, this is one of those cheapo Amazon specials. And another O-ring kit, the wig, face mask, a bunch of my open and closed end box wrenches with a little tray. I also have a bunch of them right here. So lots of wrenches. We've got a standard and metric Allen set. So these are always very handy. Inside the top of my toolbox, I have a digital voltmeter. Comes in handy once in a while. Stud finder, infrared thermometer, more Allen wrenches. I've almost never used this, but it's a it's designed to do fitting, like AN fittings, I guess. Some screwdrivers, and then of course lots of sockets and get the shit out of the way. More sockets. And oh, come on. And then the big sockets and a bunch of swivels and extenders and stuff. So you need all sorts of extenders. It's good to get different size adapters, so you can go from half to 3/8 and 3/8 to a quarter and so on. All right, we got a bunch of random spare shit. This is just like screws and Loctite and got like impact sockets, more spare sockets. It's handy to have a little power extension cords. You want to have those handy. Of course, I have a drill, a flashlight, some breaker bars. So, all the different breaker bar sizes. Oh yeah, here you go. Giant. This was the wheel bearing nut, 36 millimeter impact nut. What else we got? Latex gloves, a little drill kit, fire extinguisher, earmuffs, funnels. Actually, this has come in handy quite a few times. This is one of those wire feeds, so you can run wires through walls and stuff. Quite handy, so I recommend getting one of those. Soldering iron, glue gun, staple gun, more impact extenders, impact swivels, oil filter wrench, a bunch of random different, these are the wrench, these are where they can actually, ratchet. Those are handy. That tool I don't really ever use. Vice grips, pliers, diagonal cutters, more pliers. This is kind of handy, this little grabber, so you can grab parts that fall down into places and stuff. Definitely something to consider. More screwdrivers, more wrenches. Supposedly these sockets can grab rounded off bolts. I haven't had to use them yet, but I bought them just in case. Some crow's feet. These came in handy when I was doing the headers. More screwdrivers and nut drivers and more wrenches, some angle wrenches, shorty wrenches, little tiny wrenches, a pick kit. This is a punch set, so that's something you should consider buying. This one was from Harbor Freight, so just get a cheapo, it doesn't matter, you're going to be hitting with a hammer, so who cares, right? A magnet grabber tool that can extend. Some crescent wrenches, more pliers, saws and cutter, like a PVC cutter, hammers, more wrenches, more hammers, wires, all sorts of tape, and lots of impact sockets. Right. Almost forgot, a bunch of jack stands, and then some oil filter catch cans. Fans definitely need fans to live in Texas. Oh, and another really important thing is some good lighting. So I have these big old LEDs that are ridiculously bright, and they have a tripod that you can mount them on, so I can put them high or low. That thing's really handy, so consider getting something like that. I just got that at Home Depot. You should also have a shop vac. Definitely super useful, cleaning the car, sucking up water, whatever, you never know, it comes in really handy. I do have a pressure sprayer, but I don't really use that to clean the car. I'll show you what I do use to clean the car. Is I have a little one of these little sprayers that you can connect to the hose, and it'll just kind of foam up everywhere. And of course, I have my bucket with the microfiber mitt and a grit guard. And then I have my stack of towels and brushes and car wash stuff and all of my chemicals in a big tote. So I have leather cleaner and glass cleaner and whatever crap I have. It's all right there. All right, got it? That is literally everything I have, all the tools I have. The basics are the most critical. You want a good socket set with some good ratchets. That set I had, I think, was a couple hundred bucks, I've been using it for years and years and years. So as long as you don't lose stuff, I know people are going to shit on me about Craftsman because now they're made in China or whatever, but they're good. They're fine. Whatever, and so who cares? Of course, you need the essentials, right? Screwdrivers, wrenches, sockets, stuff like that. And what I found is for a lot of the specialty tools, so like the oil filter wrench or the giant socket for taking off the wheel bearing, that sort of stuff, you just kind of buy as needed. And frankly, what I do is I kind of compute that into the cost of doing the work at home. So when you work on the car yourself, you're saving so much money that you can go out and buy a tool that you need. For example, the giant torque wrench that I needed for the wheel bearing, it was like, I can't remember what it cost, but it wasn't that expensive. But factoring in that I had to go buy, let's say it was 50 bucks. I had to go buy a $50 tool that I now have for the rest of my life. That was totally worth it. There you go. Those are all the tools I have. And you can see it accomplishes a lot of stuff with that. So you don't need to have a bunch of specialty tools. I know a lot of people have said, get a electric impact wrench. That probably is something I will buy. Maybe even an electric ratchet. That would be probably something helpful. Probably save me some time. So those things I might consider in the future, but there you have it. So hopefully that was helpful. Consider subscribing and watching that video. Give me a thumbs up. If you have ideas for other videos of stuff you would like me to talk about or show you or whatever, feel free to put it in the comments below. You know I'll read it. And possibly even do a video on it. So we'll see you around. We'll be doing more car stuff.